Hi children, good morning. This is video number 24 in which I am going to discuss the numerical number 3.9 of the NCERT. So the question is like this. It is based on unbalanced Wheatstone's bridge. So numerical 3.9, the question is like this. They have given a diagram, circuit diagram. We have to draw the circuit diagram. Here is the circuit diagram. They have given it as A, B, C, D, and there is a resistance here, and there is a battery also here. The EMF of the battery is given to you as 10 volt. A, B, C, D, let us take this as E and let us take this as F. This resistance is 10 ohm, this is 5 ohm, this is 10 ohm, this is 5 ohm, this is 5, and this is 10. The question is, determine the current in each branch of the network. Determine the current in each branch of the network. That is the question. Means in this, what are the currents? So what we need to find to determine current in each branch? How many branches are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All the 5 branches we need to find the current. So our target is to find the current in each branch. So we have to go for Kirchhoff's laws. So let us go for Kirchhoff's rules. Let us say the current in this is I, this is I1, this is I2, here it is I3. You can take it as I1 minus I3. Here you can take it as I2 plus I3. And here you will get again I3 cancel, I1 plus I2 which is equal to I. Clear? This is how we have distributed the currents first. Now we go for Kirchhoff's laws. We apply KVL, means Kirchhoff's second law, to the loop ABDA. To the loop ABDA we apply Kirchhoff's laws. In the second law, Kirchhoff's second law, I told you, in the direction of current, the potential drop will be negative. Opposite to direction of current, the potential drop will be positive. So according to Kirchhoff's voltage law for the loop ABDA, just see, I into R, I1 into 10, which will be minus, because in the direction of current, minus 10 I1. Next, I3 into 5, in the direction of current, minus 5 I3. Next, I2 into 5, you are moving opposite to the direction of current. Since it is opposite to direction of current, this potential drop should be positive. So I will get plus 5 I2 is equal to 0. That is first equation. Next, again we apply it to BCDB. Apply it to BCDB, children. BCDB, right? First B to C minus 5 into I1 minus I3. Right, C to D, but current is flowing from D to C. You are calculating potential drop from C to D. It should be plus 10 into I2 plus I3. Next, this also opposite to direction of current, plus 5 I3 is equal to 0. So if you see the second equation contains some typical part like, see, BCDB. Minus 5 into I1 minus I3 plus 10 into I2 plus I3 plus 5 I3. So we have to simplify this equation. Like if you take it, the equation minus 5 I1 plus 5 I3 plus 10 I2 plus 10 I3 plus 5 I3 is equal to 0. Again, you simplify it, minus 5i1 plus 10i2, 10 plus 5 plus 5 plus 20i3 is equal to 0. This is equation 1, this is equation 2. How many variables are there? Three variables, children. I1, I2 and I3. There are three variables. So when there are three variables, we need to get three equations. So far we have obtained only two equations. Another equation is to be obtained. To obtain another equation, we have to go for another loop. So I go for this loop, outer loop. See this, A, D, C, E, F, A. So apply Kirchhoff's law to A, D, C, E, F, A to ensure that the loop is closed. See the first letter and last letter, that should be same, mean the loop is closed. We know that Kirchhoff's second law is applicable to only closed loops. So once the loop is closed, so we can apply Kirchhoff's second law. Now this is I2 current and the resistance is 5, so minus 5 I2. Next, minus 10 into I2 plus I3. Next, C to E, no resistance. Across the cell, minus 2 plus 10, it is rise of potential. Next, here the current is flowing like this, the current is I, but I equal to I1 plus I2. You are moving in the direction of current. See, you are traversing the loop like A to D to E to F, means you are traversing in the direction of current. So you can take this potential difference as minus. So I will get minus 10 into I1 plus I2 is equal to 0, right? So this if you expand it, I will get minus 5 I2, minus 10 I2, minus 10 I3, plus 10, minus 10 I1, minus 10 I2 is equal to 0. So take this minus 5 I2, minus 10 I2, all these minus 2, that side I write right hand side only this 10, remaining all positive. First I1 I write 10 I1, next I2 I write, here there is minus 10 I2, minus 10 I2, minus 5 I2, minus 25 I2. If you take it onto that side, it will become plus 25 I2 and plus 10 I3. Equation 3. Got the three equations? Once you get to know the three equations, you have to solve by your own technique. It is left to you. So solving three equations is left to you. Whatever the method you adopt, that is okay. So after solving the values of three equations, you will be getting the values of I1, I2 and I3. Once again, you have to solve the three equations. First equation, second equation and third equation. You have to solve these equations. Once you solve the three equations, you will get the values of I1, I2, I3 as, I'll give you the values. The value of I1 you get it as 4 by 17 ampere, I2 you get it as 6 by 17 ampere, I3 you will get it as minus 2 by 17 ampere. What does this minus sign indicate? Actually, we have taken the direction of I3 to be from B to D. Since you have got negative value, that should not be from B to D, that should be from D to B. This is the only change. I hope understood now. Now we go for current in each branch. Now tell me, what is the current in the branch AB? Current in the branch AB is I1 itself, so which is 4 by 17 ampere. Next, current in the branch BC. Current in the branch BC. BC is I1 minus I3, so I1 minus I3. What is I1? I1 is 4 by 17 minus I3 is minus 2 by 17. You are getting 6 by 17 ampere. Next, another loop is IDC. What is IDC? IDC is I2 plus I3. I2 plus I3. I2 is 6 by 17. I3 is 2 by 17 with minus. You will get the current as 4 by 17. Next loop is IAD. IAD. AD is only I2. What is the value of I2? I2 is 6 by 17 ampere. After that, what is IBD? IBD IBD. IBD is I3. I3 equal to minus 2 by 17 ampere. So these are the currents in all the branches. Okay. So the main part of this numerical is you have to get the three equations by using Kirchhoff's voltage law. Number one. Second thing is, after getting three equations, you have to find a way to solve the three equations. Once you find the three equations, once you solve the three equations, you will get to know the values of I1, I2 and I3. Just come back to the circuit, write the value of that current which is passing through that branch. Children, I hope it is clear. You have understood this. Thank you very much.